There is still time to cast your ballots in tonight's elections. Polls close in just a couple of hours from now. We are bringing you team coverage from both Minneapolis and St. Paul, where voters are picking mayors.
Yeah, that's right. You can also keep up with the results in real time through the Secretary of State's website. We'll have a link on KARE11.com. Right now, we want to go to St. Paul and Carla Holt. Hi, Carla.
Hi there. Yeah, busy night in St. Paul. And adding to the drama, the ballot itself. Now, one of the 10 candidates for mayor, Tim Holden, is listed on the ballot as Holden Holden. Tim told me tonight this is intentional and is, quote, working absolutely wonderfully in terms of the extra attention he is getting. Now, as I mentioned, he is one of 10 candidates trying to replace outgoing mayor Chris Coleman, who was running for governor. Now, with ranked choice voting, a candidate needs more than 50% of the vote to be declared the winner, which means we will likely not know the winner tonight, but we'll need to wait a few days for the results. Now, this is one of two mayor races that are extremely critical over in Minneapolis. My colleague John Crowman is watching the latest developments there. John?
Hey, thanks, Carla. I'm at Pearl Park Rec Center in South Minneapolis. It's one of the polling places here in the 11th Ward. We've seen a steady stream of voters come in here throughout the afternoon and early evening. Now, a lot of people that showed up here today still hadn't made up their mind about who they're going to rank for their top three choices. There's some city, very competitive parks board races down here, competitive city council races, but most of the attention has been on the mayor's race. And as you may have heard by now, Betsy Hodges, the incumbent, is trying to fend off 15 challengers. Top four rivals are State Rep Ray Dean, Councilmember Jacob Fry, former Hennepin Theater Trust President Tom Hoke, and former St. Thomas Law School Professor Nakima Levy Pounds. Hoke and Fry have done most of the advertising in the race, while the others have had to rely mainly on the traditional mailers and door knocks. Now, just stepped inside here a few minutes ago. They've got about 670 voters here so far today. That's about 45% of the people who are registered in this particular precinct. Citywide is a little bit lower. We heard as of 5 o'clock about a 30% turnout in Minneapolis, but still two more hours to vote, so we expect that to get back up and probably surpass 33%, which we had in 2013. We'll stay tuned. We'll actually have some results to talk about the next time we talk to you at 10. Back to you.
Thank you, John.